morning and a very Merry Christmas to each and every one of you. For Christ is born to Mary. I trust that you have, or you will be, rejoicing this day with family and friends, and have had lots of lovely Christmas gifts. Shall we begin our worship today by singing our first hymn, I Saw Three Ships? Jolly song to get us started with our service, wasn't that? Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we come to you in prayer to say thank you for this happy day. We thank you for giving us this day. Lord, we thank you for the greatest gift of all, which you granted to us 2020 years ago. Lord, we thank you for giving us your Holy Son. Thank you, Lord. Let us say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our reading today comes from Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. The birth of Jesus Christ. This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was engaged to marry Joseph, but before they married, she learned she was pregnant by the power of the Holy Spirit. Because Mary's husband, Joseph, was a good man, he did not want to disgrace her publicly, so he planned to divorce her secretly. While Joseph thought about these things, an angel of the Lord came to him in a dream. The angel said, "Joseph, descendant of David, don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife, because the baby in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this happened to bring about the Lord had said through the prophet. The virgin will be pregnant, she will have a son, and they will name him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the Lord's angel had told him to do. Joseph took Mary as his wife, but he did not have a sexual relation with her until she gave birth to the son, and Joseph named him Jesus. Our next hymn is one of my all-time favourite Christmas song hymns. At every Christmas service I've taken, I've included it. I have only taken two Christmas services, and one of those is now, but I've included it in them both, so that's every Christmas service that I've taken. So let us sing our second hymn, All Good Christians Rejoice. Within our church that every Sunday in Advent that we light a candle and for our as part of our Christmas traditions. Each candle represents something significant. So the first candle that we lit in week one was hope. The second candle that we lit in week two was peace. The third candle that we lit in week three was joy. The fourth candle that we lit in week four was love. Now, today we get to light our fifth candle, which is the Christmas candle. I don't have our actual wreath with me, so I have created my own. I say created, I've ordered my own wreath. And as this the weeks have gone on, we have been lighting our candles here at home. I've only had one near miss. I've only nearly set the wreath on fire once, so I feel like we're doing quite well. So I will light our candles and then let us pray. We light the candle of hope. We light the candle of peace. We light the candle of joy. We light the candle of love. And finally, we light the candle that is our Christmas candle to celebrate the Lord being born. Let us pray. Lord, help us today to show a little light in the bleak and grey situation that we might be living in. Prompt us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and equip us with your word. Lord, we pray that you will give us courage. Amen. Now let's come to our third hymn in our Christmas Day service, which is a very well-known hymn, and I'm sure we've all sung it in our primary schools, Christmas carols, everything. O Little Town of Bethlehem.
You're very small.
You're very short.
You're very young.
How many ways can we put each other down to make others feel small or insignificant? Our carol speaks of a town in that way. O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Bethlehem was small and insignificant. We see this as we read Micah chapter 5 verse 2. But ye Bethlehem of Ephraim, though you are small. If you feel small in any way, do you know that God does not despise small things, whether towns or people, animals, anything? We shall see it might be true that all good things come in small packages. We find this when Samuel chooses David to be the king in 1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 12. As well as here in Bethlehem, who uses this small, insignificant place to bless the whole world. In our celebrity-based culture, it's so easy to forget the small and the insignificant, but God does not, and we may miss out on some of his most amazing plans if we do. In Micah's time, the people of God has been through doom and destruction, exile and eviction. But now Micah, chapter 5, God tells of his plan. Don't you just love it when there's a plan, especially when it means providing a way out of the mess that you might have found yourself in? It was like that, this, for God's people in the time of Micah. God wanted to tell them that one who would rule and reign would be their peace. God's people may well have scoffed as they heard it would be the little town of Bethlehem that would be the place where God unveiled himself. But God does not despise small. And 700 years later, just as Micah said, God revealed himself to all mankind in Bethlehem. I believe that God is still intervening in our world, helping us out, guiding us, so not to let us despise the small and insignificant things in life, just because maybe, wrapped up in small packages, is a plan that God seeks to offer each one of us. After all good things do come in small packages. Over 2,000 years ago today, something so small, so tiny, changed the entire world forever. We've now come to the time where we are going to pray for ourselves and others. So, shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we come to you with prayer and say thank you for your Son, Jesus, who was born today. Lord, we thank you for the generosity of all the kind people who have donated to Operation Christmas Child, given children in poverty-stricken countries, giving children a present for them to open today. Lord, we pray for heart tips, giving children a wonderful gift of exciting stationery, food banks giving families and individuals food for Christmas dinner and festive goodies. Lord, we pray for all those families who are missing their loved ones this year, and instead of their loved ones being around their dining room table, they're with you, Lord. Lord, we pray for those who are on their own this festive time. We pray that you will be with them. Lord, we thank you for Age Concern and the Samaritans, who work with people offering support to battle loneliness. Lord, we thank you for letting us celebrate today as we are. Today could have been so different, but we thank our government for keeping us safe. Lord, it's been so hard not being able to come to your house. Our church during this year, but we thank you for not leaving us, not forgetting about us. We thank you for giving us your Son, Jesus Christ, and for giving us his birthday when we can come together in unison to celebrate his birth and him changing the world. Lord, we thank you for our church members who make this, that our church still standing in such magnificent splendour. We thank you for our stewards. We thank you for our church members who clean in line our church in line with the COVID protocols. We thank you for those who tend to the gardens within our church, making it look so pretty. We thank you for our church secretary and for those church members who do so much behind the scenes that go on, that may go unnoticed, but are so critical in our church life. Lord, we pray for our families. We know that today might not be how some people had planned to be spending today, but we pray for our families and we pray for a happy and healthy 2021. Amen. We have now come to the end of our service, nearly. We've just got our final hymn. So I don't think we could have a Christmas Day service without singing this magnificent hymn. So let us sing, O Come All Ye Faithful. We have now reached the end of our Christmas Day service. Shall we share the grace together? The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and love of God and fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now, forevermore. Amen. I wish you all a magical rest of your day and I hope you have a wonderful new year. Thank you very much for watching and thank you very much for participating in our Christmas Day service. I'll see you soon. Merry Christmas.